Hey guys, press the bell icon and never miss a video from Iola DIY.
Hey guys, so I have another tutorial for all of you today. Today I will be teaching you all how to make this beautiful layout with a 3D hot air balloon on it. It's a very simple process and I really hope you guys will enjoy my video. To begin with, I went to Google and I just typed hot air balloon template, and using that I just found a hot air balloon. And I had printed it on a 6x6 inch of paper. Basically, I didn't wanted my balloon to be bigger than 6 inch. After printing it out, I used that as a template, and I had cut about 7 of these balloons. Sorry, 9 of these balloons. And now I'm going to be de-stressing all the edges of these balloons. My flat balloons are now de-stressed. The next step is going to be folding them into half. Make sure you do this step properly because you wouldn't want the half of the balloon to be misaligned. The better you fold it, the better is going to be the shape of your hot air balloon when we form the 3D object. Once you are done folding 7 of these flat balloons, you're going to take one flat balloon. And on top of it, you're going to stick it. I'm using my ATG glue. You can use any kind of glue to stick your balloon halves. So here you'll see me that I'm adding glue and I am sticking one part onto another one. So this will basically give it a fan sort of a structure. I'm not sure, but back in India, there were these small party decorations which would just open up like this. It was a flat thing, and then you open it, it would just convert into a full round. They would look super pretty. So I'm not sure if you can find them here in America, but this is something like that, but just half of it. If you actually want, you can make full round and convert this into an ornament by adding a string to it. The structure of my 3D hot air balloon is almost done, but I decided to add some more layers such that it looks more fuller. Once I'm satisfied with the shape of my balloon, I'm going to add some string to the bottom part of it such that it looks more visually pleasing. Now my hot air balloon is fully ready. I'm going to start composing my layout. To begin with, I'm going to de-stress the edges such that everything blends in properly. I've taken another strip of paper and I'm basically using my fingers to tear it down. This process, I'm going to do it slowly because I want the tearing part to be done in a little straighter fashion. I'm adding some water to it, such that paper becomes a little soft and soggy and it is easy to fold. Once my paper is folded into my desired shape, I'm going to de-stress the edge. Make sure that you de-stress all the components because that would make your entire layout blend into each other. The next step is adding some texture to your layout. For this, I'm using one of the stencils which was given in the kit, and I'm using my paper texture paste and spatula to apply it all over my paper. Now let's add some color to the layout. I'm using some color bloom sprays in different colors. I'm going to list down each and every product which I've used in this particular layout in the description box below. While misting your layout, make sure you have a water bottle and some tissue paper handy. Wherever the color intensity is a little higher, you might want to settle it down by adding some water and wiping it down with some tissue. Here I'm using Metallics by Finnabear, and I'm going to give more color to my layout. I'm using a paintbrush to define some areas on my layout. Again, make sure that you mist it with some water and tissue paper such that all the colors they blend properly and nothing looks way too distinct. Now in the next step, I'm using a different stencil, and these are the new stencils by Finnabear. And I'm gonna again same use paper texture paste and apply it on the small strip of paper which I had. Now I'm going to dry my entire layout using a hairdryer. I'm going to add some more texture by using a black pen, basically a black marker, and drawing lines all around. Now let's add that small strip of paper which we had set apart into the center. I'm again using my ATG glue gun. You can use any kind of glue which you have. I'm going to add some more water so that I can fold the edges of the middle strip of paper.
To give more texture to the layout, I'll be using some stamps. They instantly transform the layout and they kind of give more depth and more layers to your layout. The next step is taking some white gesso and using a paintbrush, I'm gonna sprinkle it all over my layout. Again, more texture, more details can be seen by this step. I will do the similar process by adding some black color gesso to my layout. Now the base of my layout is ready. The next step is composing and adding all the elements which I have collected onto the layout. Here you will see that I have added a twine to the base of my hot air balloon that again gives it more detail and adds more definition to it. The composition process is again very hit and trial method, and what I usually do is that I try to put everything together and then I keep on changing whatever I feel won't fit. I've embossed some chipboard pieces. The process is very simple. I took the chipboard piece, added some VersaFine ink on it, and added an embossing powder and used my heat gun. This process would instantly transform your chipboard and really helps in adding details to your layout. All the flowers which you see me using in this layout are from Prima Marketing, and majority of them from our new collection called Apricot Honey. And even the ephemera which I'm using is from Prima Marketing, from the collection Apricot Honey. Oh, I'm so sorry, not Apricot Honey, Autumn Sunset. So as far as when ephemera goes, I always recommend that if you're planning to make layouts or cards along with flowers, don't forget to order yourself a packet of ephemera. Because they are very well coordinated with the project and they help in adding layers, as well as they act as perfect fillers for the project. I generally give a lot of texture and depth to my composition by adding tons of die cut pieces, and the majority of dies which you'll see me using in this particular layout are from Fantasy. It's a Russian company. I used to design for them and the dies are amazing. They are really good quality and they have beautiful, beautiful designs out there. Once my composition is ready, I'm going to finish it off with some finishing touches. For that, I generally use a lot of soft matte gel on my layout and add art stones as well as glass glitter to it. I'm using glass glitter called Gold Rush by Prima Marketing. And while the soft matte gel is still wet, I'm gonna apply this glass glitter. In order to balance out everything, I'll take some white gesso in a dabbing brush. Again, this brush is by Fenabear, and I am going to add some white gesso marks, basically dab it all across my layout. Everything will balance out in this one, in this step, and it will just seem like that the whole layout was created with all the matching elements.
Here I'm just adding some black splitters and white splitters using black gesso and white gesso. I decided to add some more textures, and for that I'm using a white crackle paint on my layout. I'm randomly dabbing it across my layout, and this would basically crack up when it dries and again gives another beautiful texture. Layout looks super pretty. Now let's add some crystals to it. I'm using Sayed crystal from the Autumn Sunset collection, and I generally use glue gun because there are so many textures on my paper, the adhesive tend to fall out, so I always stick it using a glue gun. Really hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I'm completely in love with my layout. It's pretty different from what I usually do. In case you like it, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button, like button and comment on it. It really keeps me going. And also, all the products which I have used in this particular video will be listed down in the description box below. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.